Morning, Peter. What do you have for us today?
Today I have a big model of the rangefinder Oskar Barnack developed specially for the market introduction of the first Leica camera, the Leica I. And this rangefinder was very important for the market introduction, and I would like to explain how it works.
What exactly is the rangefinder?
The rangefinder, in German Entfernungsmesser, is an optomechanical tool with which you can measure the distance to the object you want to focus. And it's an optomechanical tool where you use triangulation to measure the distance by using two light passes. So this is one light pass where you directly look at the object you want to focus, and the second light pass is going here through, and by triangulation you can measure the distance. And the measurement happens when you look through this the ocular, you see two images of the object, and when you turn this wheel, these two images are coming together, and when it's coincident, you have measured the distance to the object you want to focus, and you can read here on the wheel which distance you have.
And why exactly is this object so big?
Oh, that's a good question. This is a large model of the rangefinder you use. A normal rangefinder is in that size. But the reason for the big model is that in 1939 there was a celebration of 100 years photography, and due to this event, Leitz built up such a big model and gave it to the Deutsche Museum in Munich, yeah, as a representative for photography, I would say, yes.
Why did Barnack decide to build the rangefinder?
He recognized you can't estimate how far is it from the camera to the object you want to focus. And that was the idea of Oskar Barnack, to build an accessory, the rangefinder. The name is FODIS. FODIS is the name for the tool and the leather case in combination. The rangefinder itself, the name was FOFAIR. And how do you use this? So you put it on the camera here, and before you focus with the lens, you can measure here the distance. And when you have measured this, you can read here the distance to the object. And then you can focus the lens at that distance precisely. The focus here and the focus distance here is in line, are the same. And now you can take the picture by moving a little bit the camera so that the coincidence image is there, and then you can push the button. That is the way you can use this camera. And it was a very practical way because there is no mat screen and you don't have the time to measure the distance to the object by a ruler or so. And the idea of Oskar Barnack was to realize snapshot photography, to capture the moment, in German, the Momentaufnahme. And that was very important, this combination to have, to take pictures fast. Fast in comparison to that, what at that time, mat screen cameras could realize.
So the FODIS made focusing more precise, but not necessarily more convenient, right?
Yeah, you are right, and that was the thinking of Barnack too. But it was a long way to implement this rangefinder functionality into a camera. That was the next step Oskar Barnack and his team did. They developed the Leica II, where they implemented the rangefinder, this functionality, into the camera. Here, this is the Leica II here. And here you can see the rangefinder is implemented, and by coupling with the camera, you can directly focus with the lens, and the information about the focusing position is given in the rangefinder directly.
Looking at the Leica II now, I see that there are two oculars on the back. What does it have to do with that?
So two functionalities are implemented in the camera, but different views you have to use. Two oculars. So one is for the use of the rangefinder here, and the other one is to framing the image. So in this, the rangefinder is much smaller than the FODIS here, and to compensate the small size, and magnification of a Galilean viewfinder is implemented, with a magnification of 1 by 1.5. So the accuracy of the focusing is the same like using this one here, the FODIS. But now you have the combination of focusing the lens and measuring by the rangefinder. And that was a real big step. And in the advertisement you can read automatic focusing. And this is very funny. From today's perspective, it's not autofocus, but at that time, directly you look through the image, do the framing, and then you do focusing, framing again, and push the button.
So this also contributed to the general success of the camera, right?
Yes, you're right. The success of the camera depended not only on the compactness of the camera and the lens and the good performance of the whole tools. It depended also on the rangefinding application you could use here. And to implement it into the Leica II was the next step, which helped to make it easier for much more customers to use and to make it more faster to use. And as I already said, the Momentaufnahme was much easier to realize, yes.
So how does the implementation of the rangefinder into the Leica II work exactly?
So when I disassemble the lens, you can see here a lever which will be moved by the lens itself, by focusing. The position of this lever gives the information to the rangefinder in which distance the lens is focused. And this functionality is still in the M camera today. And so we can say the soul of Oscar Barnack is still buried in the M camera. And this is fascinating that nearly 100 years ago that Oscar Barnack did the first inventions, and now we still have it in our camera, modern camera, yes.
I just saw that you took off the lens from the Leica II, which you couldn't do for the Leica I. Does this mean that you can use different focal lengths on the Leica II?
Yes, now we have a screw mount, and with the screw mount we can change the lens systems, so we can change the focal lengths. And this is another challenge Oscar Barnack had to face, because different focal length lenses have different movements by focusing. And to compensate that, you need a special gear within each focusing mount of each focal length, so that the information about focusing is given in the right way to the rangefinder. And this was also a very big step for photography with a 35mm camera.
And on modern M cameras, we know now there's only one ocular on the back. How did this develop?
Oh, this is a big step, yes, because the Leica II was designed and published in the market in 1930. And what you are talking now about is about the M system. The market introduction was 1954, so nearly 25 years in between. And for this, the market introduction was done with the M3. I have it here. The M3 was the first step where we implemented 50, 75 and 90 millimeter frames. And that's the reason why we name it M3. Most important is that instead of a screw mount, now we have an M mount. So it's easier to detach lens and camera. But the functionality of the lever here is still the same. Let's have a look at it in a different view. Let's talk about again about the Leica II or the Leica III. The disadvantage of this camera was that when you use different focal length lenses, you had to use an additional viewfinder to see the frame. And so you have to focus, to frame, and this is implemented into the M3. Into one view. And this was a big step, I think.
Compared to the Leica I and to the Leica II, it seems that the M3 is now way more convenient, but are there still some challenges in taking photographs with the M3?
In principle, it's always a challenge to use an M at the beginning, because you look through the rangefinder here and you see which image you will have. In principle, of the frame, you can see the frame. And sometimes when you have a longer focal length, you see more than you take with a lens. On the other side, you can see how it looks like in terms of focus and defocus, the unsharpness, the background, how will it look like. This image you have to create in your brain. And you will see the result later. But when you take the picture, you will not see it. You have to imagine how will the picture look like by choosing the aperture and focusing and all these things. And this is a big challenge for them. Was a challenge and is still a big challenge. Today you have digital cameras and you can directly look later. In former times it was more challenging because you had first take the pictures, then to develop, and then you saw it. And the time frame between was much longer. On the other side, once you have learned it, I think you will never want to do something different, because this training to have the image in your brain and to see it virtually helps you to create the images, and you can do it with a M camera. And the second advantage is, due to if you have 50 millimeters, the frame is smaller than the whole image you see through the rangefinder. So you see when there is something coming in, something is going out, and then you know at which time you have to push the button. And all these things helps photographers to improve their style. My thinking, it's like a fountain pen. A fountain pen is not easy to use at the beginning, but once you manage it, you don't want to change it. And it's like an M camera, yes. Once you manage it, it's your favorite, yes.